Good morning, or rather good day, everyone. I want to talk to you about my brand and how I created my brand value. I would like to talk about our philosophy, about how we went about achieving certain things. And when I came back from the USA and France after I finished my studies, I came back with two very important lessons. The first lesson was, be true to your DNA. Do what you are the expert at. Put your state into the clothes, or put your country into the clothes. The second thing that I learned was, be international from the onset. I never looked at myself as just a designer who was designing for India. I took my Indianness, I took my Goanness, yes, but I wanted to be out there. And that is what was one of the philosophies that I looked at. And I said, how am I going to be new in this place? I looked around when I came back in 1988, there were two aesthetics in fashion. One was based on this Maharaja style, which still continues for the bridal market. The other was this Hollywood, this Bollywood hippie kitsch kind of brightness that went on. There was a third aesthetic that was lacking. That third aesthetic had nothing to do with a visual aesthetic. It spoke to Indians and foreigners about yoga, about Ayurveda, about the calm and peace of South Indian temples, about Indian geometry, about Indian mathematics. And I said, I am going to run after that. I am going to give this country a philosophy that's not hanging on these racks. So I gave my country minimalism, resort wear, and eco-friendly, at a time when the words were not even coined. And I always said that, you know, what I wanted to do was to give the Indian woman more options, and then we did the same for the men. My friend Simone Tata, when I turned 40, she told me, she said, Wendell, you've turned 40, I want you to give every Saturday to charity, from 9 o'clock to 12 o'clock. And she said, not by signing a check. I want you to give charity by actually doing charity. And I began to do charity, and because of that charity, I could give the world the unique concept which I did for a collection called the Visionaire Collection. I could give the world, for the first time, the visually challenged could read their clothes because I put Braille on clothing. And it was never done worldwide. I recovered a forest in 7 years to start the revival of our Goan Kunbi Sari. I did many things. We still work for the visually challenged, for children of parents with AIDS, with teenagers with AIDS, with a handicap. And I'll tell you what all this has bought me in the end, which is the next thing that one needs for a good brand value. It has bought a lot of trust and respect from the public. And that is very important. We cannot stay in our own little selfish worlds. We need to step out of our zone. I'm a designer, yes, but I also did movies. I wrote books, etc. Explore this. We associated ourselves with other brands who wanted to associate with us. The Wendell Rodricks brand went on to Polo, the mint with a hole. And we did the strategy so well that in just about 2 or 3 months, they made sure that they made 10 crores of profit selling the small mint. We attached ourselves to a coffee company and sold coffee. And everywhere we could go out and do something and sell the brand name, we sold it. We have reached a point today, I remember when I started my career, I said, I'm making these very simple shirts and trousers, sometimes dresses, etc. But they are made of humble cotton. We are reviving Malka cotton, for example. We are doing things which other people are not doing. How do we make it look sexy? And what we did was, for the first 7 years of my career, I made sure that we shot only in black and white. It was a strategy. And because we shot in black and white, we made it look like art. And people desired it, and they wanted to come and buy the clothes. And that's when Germany, the world's largest garment fair, came knocking at my door and said, we want to show your clothes, because there is something happening over there. When Paris, the biggest prêt-à-porter salon in the world, most prestigious, wanted to invite an Indian designer, they approached me first. And they said, come and show in Paris, because we want to show this new. This is not about the bright colors and embroideries of Paris, of India. This is a different lexicon and a completely different ethos. So I think after you've sorted your philosophy and the points of yours that are positive and done a certain amount of charity, I still do charity every Saturday, I work from 9 to 12. You get the truth from the public, and the public wants to buy into you. And as Simon Tata said, don't make those very high-priced clothes. Go for the middle level, because the more you sell, like we sell our cars and whatever, that's what you will achieve. About 3 years ago, I said, how long am I going to continue in this? Because I want to focus on my Moda Goa museum. We said we live in a big house, two gay men in a big house, and four dogs, and this huge 450-year-old house in Goa. So I said, let me give it away to as charity to Goa and to the country and make the first costume museum in the country. We are opening next year for sure in February. And I am very glad to say that I was also among, I think, the first Indian designer to give my label away to a successor who is not for my family. I know others have done it. I know Tarun has given it to his son, or Ritu Kumar has given it to her son. But I wanted to make sure it goes to the most talented person. Now, in the process of building this brand value, and you know, whether it was starting Lakme Fashion Week or whatever it is, we wanted to make sure that the brand continued, and continued with the times. I was the first fashion designer, and I'm proud to say it, and it sounds like a boast, but it's not. I'm just saying it because one has to say it. I was the first one to actually start my own web page, and I was shocked that no other designer did it. We want to start e-retail very seriously, and we are on the job. We already started it 2 years ago. But we are now wanting to spread out. Do you know, in the year 1947, Christian Dior became famous because he bought out a new shape. But in only 2 years, he learned the art of licensing. And that is what my company is going to do today. We are going to license ourselves. We are going to put ourselves out there. We are open to sell anything which has the Wendell Rodricks philosophy at its back, whether it's clean makeup, whether it is clean linen, whether it's organic cotton, whether it is sustainable cotton. We want to pick to liaise with those people and take this label forward into the future. Thank you.